January 16th. Can I get a motion? Second one, that? Move the minutes, the cases? All in favor? That brings us to citizen comments. Before we start citizen comments, I just wanted to mention that there are one of the seats on the school board, two?
Two of the seats.
Two of the seats on the school board, so tomorrow is the last day to sign up, so anyone's interested, go to the town office, see town clerk, and find your name.
Rachel.
It's a good time.
It is a good time.
And it's a worthwhile endeavor.
Very worthwhile.
And Scott, even if you want to move to Jackson.
Do it all.
Anybody's interested, want to talk, give me a call. Or stop by the store tomorrow, happy to talk to you about time improvement, what's involved, and any other questions that you have. It's well worth it.
So, citizen comments, are there any? Here, then we'll move on. FYI's. Good, old business. Recommendations regarding peaceful proposal. That's on this one for particular reason, or?
Well, you folks, I had a note to bring back next month. There were, you received a note from Gail and Jess, and the board was just going to review it, seeing if they had any comments or any edits for principal in Jess. That would be, that's all. But if there's nothing at this time.
Yeah, it does seem to kind of sit there, see a few other job done, and yeah. We'll have to go on anyway, so. Anything on the pavilion update?
Yes, we have some young people here today to present you an updated progress report. So if I could ask for the mom.
You can take that mic too.
Oh, yeah, this is a mic too.
So, tonight, Bill and I are going to be giving you an update on the building project, mainly on the project that we're developing. The project is mainly a bond project because most of the goods and services are going to be donated and won't have any cost. But the reason that we're making that we're developing this budget anyway is because last update, we had some questions about how much it would cost in donations overall. And it's also just a good sense when we develop a budget. We're putting the role of a general contractor who is at the head of the project. We were trying to pull together all of the different components and the subcontractors, like the engineer or the architect. Speaking of which, we have some business loans to some contractors, which brings me to the point.
So, the beginning of this week, we wrote business letters to contractors and engineers. I wrote this one to Jonathan McDougall. He is an engineer at ATB Engineering in Colony, New Hampshire. We are proposing letters to other volunteers,
this is going to use the skill of developing a business letter to write fundraising letters in the future. Alright, so here you can see the general budget that we've been developing. And in the interest of time, and also because we have all of the components of this line being developed, I I'm going to be telling you about this specific news from Bernie Sanders to Haiti about the timber framing. So in Colorado, you can see a description which tells you what the home is about. So some of them are going to set the home with pegs, and some of them are services like the timber frame shack drives, which that's a service to them or not. In Colorado, you can see the vendor or subcontractor who is the person that is supplying materials or doing the services. For example, we've got John McDougall, who's the engineer we mentioned earlier, or we've got Pegs, who's making us the pegs. And the bottom is the labor, which is how much time and labor that will take and how many people. Some of the sections are put in because they are services and goods. In column D, you can see the amount of goods and the real cost. The cost that we have paid for each thing. Some of these are for them because they're not goods, they're services. In column E, you can see our estimated total for the money. And at the bottom, you can see our estimated total for the total items which. Now, in column F, you can see the actual cost, which we haven't broken yet. And indeed, you can see the buildings, which is the difference between what we thought it was going to cost and what it actually costs. There's probably going to be large buildings because most of these businesses are going to be free. This other one's worksheet shows you how to get from the brand foundation up to the frame with no roof, which you can see here in the top drawing. So it doesn't, this illustration does not include the foundation or the roof. Frame has more general project updates.
Right now we are developing an entire budget from response letters.
That's what we just talked about.
Yep, and then right now we're getting Rotten Rock to source the foundation of a donation to us. And we're getting shop drawings fine-tuned from Curtis Milton.
In the near future, the system is going to be taking a four-sheet field trip on February 8th to Sandwich, New Hampshire, where we're going to see why. We're going to be drafting fundraising letters to local organizations and businesses to raise funds. Chris Doctor is going to be doing his drafting lessons, which means that he's showing us how to draw buildings, draft buildings. And there's going to be a demonstration of milling and roof sheeting, which are the wood planks that go between the frame and above the frame and the main roof. That's going to be done by Mr. Bushwell right here on February 15th, which is on the beach.
We're going to have an excavation site right out here at late March.
That's when we're going to excavate for the foundation.
Our joinery work will be late April, early March, May, and the raising will be late May.
The joiners will be put together all the parts of the frame and the reasons when we actually raise the frame. And that's what the owners will be showing you.
Any questions or comments?
Have you guys really enjoyed this whole process?
Yeah.
It's been great.
It's been really good. We got to review the building plans and we really kind of navigate through them. We saw the engineers, the calculations we did to make sure the snow wouldn't be too much. One thing that was really interesting.
Yeah, and Chris Doctor, an engineer, just came in multiple times to show us some drawings.
Oh, one more question.
Can you excavate frozen ground?
We're gonna wait a little bit around the talk about. But Rothenock was also going to be doing, providing that service, but they said March was the best time for them. Otherwise, they're so busy in April. So that's the best time for them to do it.
Thanks, man. Good job. Next up is the approval of the job descriptions. Does anyone want it? Oh, thanks. I had one of my glasses, so maybe they didn't move it. Are there any structural issues? Consider personnel actions, approval of the job descriptions. There isn't any changes we want to make at this point. We did approve the number 1 through 3. So then again, a motion to approve the job descriptions for 1 through 3.
Second.
Are there any discussions or questions or changes that we have to do? Hearing none, all those in favor? Unanimous. Is this one? I guess it's only general. This is public care.
It can't be the child care.
So approved across by Terry Scribner for the new taxes. Second. Any discussion questions?
I'll hand her back a minute.
All those in favor? Unanimous. Any questions on the current budget? Comments? Reports?
Just real briefly, you had mentioned you on board meeting next Thursday at 6 o'clock. Prior to that, 5:30 is an executive board meeting. And the only other piece would be we had a strategic plan competency-based education forum on the 18th of January, and we hope to have more. I do recommend if you get a chance, go to the SAE9 website. Presentation is on there. We're compiling information that was developed by the community, and we hope to have more community forums, really. And that's it for me.
I don't really have anything for you to see.
Yes. Brings us back to citizen comments. Are there any? Ellie?
So sorry to bring this up at the preschool point, but there is folks wondering if we're going to have that be a ballot vote when we bring that forward at the March meeting. And I'm just stepping on the process for that, and if we need to put that into action, so that will be a ballot vote now.
It was to have a little bit of time in the reading, so we address that at the end of our meeting, but that's a good time to do that now. So, I have heard some questions from you about the process and how that works and what happens this evening and then what happens at the annual district meeting. So, this evening at 6, we'll be having our public hearing. From a process standpoint, the school board has adopted a budget to present at the annual district meeting. We did that at our last meeting. And so this evening is a chance for the legislative body, meaning everyone here, and anyone that's at our annual district meeting to challenge and question us on the warrant articles that we've adopted for the legislative body to consider on March 2nd, March 1st. So this evening, there won't be any voting from the people in the audience this evening. Tonight is a chance for you to question and challenge us on what we do there so that you can be informed on what's in our budget that were presented on March 1st. On the evening of March 1st, the Legislative Body does have the opportunity to amend the budgets that we present, and that takes motions and seconds and discussions and then passage of those, and then we consider the warrant articles on top of that. Those warrant articles are not voted on by ballot. They're voted on by the Legislative Body that's present the evening of March 1st. There is a process for calling for a secret ballot. The reason I bring that up is I've heard some people that are concerned about being afraid to vote in public. And that vote in public is an oral vote, so it's a yay or nay vote. And when there's a large crowd present, it really doesn't seem to be any hesitation on the yays to vote yay and the nays to vote nay. But I understand that most of the time we have less people here tonight, usually at our annual district meeting, and people are sometimes afraid to do that publicly, to voice themselves and say, this is how I either support or don't support this. There is a way to do a secret ballot on the evening of the annual district meeting. If anyone wants to learn about that and have questions about that, I'd ask you to contact me after the meeting or another day. And I'd be happy to walk someone through that process and understand how that occurs. And so that's kind of how the process has been unfolding here. So thank you, everyone, for bringing that
up. Gary, do you have a time for March 1st?
6 o'clock.
It's
7. 7 o'clock.
I believe Lisa was working on it. I'm not 100% sure she's confirmed it at this point, but I believe there will be, yes.
For the first article, I think that requires a motion to be as well. I think, but I can talk to them about that.
Yeah. Maybe say it a little louder,
Jen was showing me that Tim was saying he's considering a ballot vote for Article 1 on March 1st. I'm not sure if the moderator can call for a ballot vote or not. Can we know?
No, it would be a petition article. So you can find a signature to be submitted, and then you could go to a ballot vote.
So yeah, the rest of this reveal that this evening. So to have a ballot vote at the annual district meeting, it takes a petition from the Legislative Body and from the floor people here. And it takes a petition that would request a secret ballot, and it takes 5 signatures on that petition to present to the moderator. So anyone that wants to present that petition would have to stand and address the moderator and say, Mr. Chair, I have a petition to call for a secret ballot. And that's the process for calling for a secret ballot. And then everyone here, just the people that are here for that evening, come up and vote by a yes or no. Simple yes or no. You rip off it, rip it in half, you put the yes or the no into the ballot box, and then it's counted by the moderator when the vote is complete. And I think that you have an hour.
No. Once the question's asked, once everybody's voted, the moderator typically will say, if it were a long vote, you'd have to leave the ballot open for an hour's worth of time. Right. But on a typical article,
it's up to the
you give an all call. Is anybody not voted yet? And then 5 in the morning, and then count the votes.
Yes?
Can you just explain the March 1st meeting is board articles only for the school board? Is that what you're saying?
That's correct. So it's not the town.
So whatever passes that night, then town meeting, these warrants you're talking about are not coming out of the town.
They are not, no.
And where would we see what these warrants are?
They're on the budget up front on the last back page. There are 4 articles in the
building. Oh, okay. I see. Yep, draft.
And at 6 o'clock tonight, we'll be going over each of those articles more thoroughly.
Thank you.
Anything else this matter? We will move on then.
This time.
Board member issues, next meeting, March 1st, 6:30 here for this meeting.
My board member issue. Can I just?
Sure.
I did not have the packet for the SAU board boards. Can we just make sure that I get the packet for the next SAU meeting? I don't know why, because I was getting them, but then this last one I didn't get, so.
The last one?
The one last week.
You probably worked out with the program, so is it?
Yeah, I picked it up on the meeting that I was meeting.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just to make it happen.
I mean, it's pretty.
It's pretty.
It was really good. It's a very good meeting.
Yeah.
Fails?
No.
I just want to say I'm very disappointed in those program studies. People, you guys have looked at, very disappointed.
The classes got?
Yeah.
That might be difficult to have a discussion about that. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to bring it up in the SAU meeting beforehand about that. I mean, that's supposed to be the board, pushing on a different board in April. So let's put it under old business, Kevin, the sheriff to talk about at some point.
Keith, were you at the meeting?
No.
There's a sign, there's no room. Have you been able to do it?
Jerry, one thing, while you got 10 minutes, there are 12 things I need. At the end of the meeting, before you, board members leave, we need your signatures on the blue ball.
Thank you.
Good afternoon.